So here we have the new Mate 20X. Hi.
Hey.
What's up?
How's it going, Shabax?
How are you?
I'm good.
So what do you think compared to your Pixel 3 XL?
It's not the same thing, you know?
It's bigger. This is bigger. XL, XL.
Yeah, I mean, this is, oh, look, I think the this conversation we should be having, you can't compare the Pixel 3 XL to this. You can compare the Pixel 3 to the Mate 20 or Mate 20 Pro, but this is a whole new, this is a whole different category. This is like phablet, the phablet is back. Yeah. This is phablet. Look at the size of this compared to the size of my head. I mean, look at it.
All the tablets used to be 7-inch, now it's a phone.
That's a phone. But the 7-inch, but there's so little bezel that the casing is so small, right?
There's a nice little bezel.
I mean, it's not bad.
What do you think about the notch?
I think it's great. I like the notch. It's good. I think this is interesting because it's affordable, relatively speaking, affordable. And it's a big screen for the people who want a big screen. And did you see how interesting it was that Huawei positioned this as a gaming device?
Yeah, with that controller. It's like half of a Switch. You get the Switch on one side.
Yeah, that controller looked a little janky. But this thing, you know.
What do you think about this back?
Yeah, it's the same back as on the Mate 20 Pro and on the Mate 20, you know, the little ridge glass back.
Maybe it's popular.
People like that to have a distinguishable back, and that's kind of like a Huawei thing.
I think it's, you know, what's interesting about this is the battery, 5,000 something milliamp hour. You know, it's got the same camera system as the Mate 20. And so, you know, it's like a Mate 20, but blown up in size, 7.2 inches. That's a lot.
Did they keep it at 1080p so they can have long battery life,
and
right?
Also so that, you know, they don't, the price doesn't go crazy.
Well,
this is an OLED,
Mate
20 is an IPS.
There's lots of OLED going on.
So how about this iPhone Max? That's also a big one, right? The new.
Yeah, but it's not the same league. You can't compare them. Remember, the Mate 20 and the Mate 20 X are the entry-level price in this series. The Mate 20 Pro is the fancy one. And then the Mate 20 RS is the really fancy one. 2,000 euros for the Mate 20 RS?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean.
How about this optics are getting very interesting, right? They're claiming to have a new big sensor that nobody has.
That's on the Pro. So again, that's only on the Pro, right? And the RS. So you gotta look at the specs. There's really very little difference between the cameras on this and the camera of the P and the P20 Pro. Right? The P20 and P20 Pro had a monochrome sensor, and that's gone and been replaced by a wide angle. That's the only difference. Of course, there's a faster Kirin in there, so you can do more AI faster. And so it's all about computational photography nowadays. Right?
I thought it was quite amazing. I don't know if anybody else does the thing where you're in color and everything else is out of black and white.
Yeah, Nokia's been doing this for years. The thing about it is that you can now do it in real time and it can track the subject.
That's
exactly.
Video, right?
Yeah, it's video.
A little bit new. But if it can do that, I would think it could do the bokeh thing that I would like to have, like where the video is in
maybe.
Bokeh. Maybe. So if you have to choose one of the three or four, which one?
Probably Mate 20 Pro.
The Pro.
I mean, this is great. No, I don't think I need that much real estate.
Right. Cool. So busy?
Always busy.
Your blogging is busy?
Mostly it's my podcast. I mobiletechpodcast.com. That's where it's at.
So who are you interviewing? What's happening here?
Usually it's other journalists. An hour every week, audio only. We talk about anything that's mobile. And it includes cars, because cars are mobile. So, you know.
Cars. You've got a Tesla at home.
Yeah, I do have a Tesla.
You returned it or are you keeping it?
Why would I return it? I waited 2.5 years to get my Tesla.
Because maybe you want the... Yeah. I don't know. You
I have a Porsche.
Model,
I have
Model
a Tesla.
Four.
I have everything
you
I need.
You want the new, the fast one, the one that goes in 2 seconds, right? What's it called? The Roadster 2.
The Roadster, I don't have the money for that.
Okay.
Cool. You know, everybody's got a budget.
But you're charging at home, and how is your electricity bill going up?
Not much. No? This is U.S. U.S. electricity costs nothing where I live.
All right.
So, you know, it's like the nice thing is it costs me about a third of the price of using gas to get around. And that's a big difference, you know. And it's fast, and it's comfortable, and it's quiet, and it's super high tech. What else do you want?
Yeah, Elon Musk is cool.
I think he's an interesting guy.
Yeah,
sure.
He's getting us to Mars. That's so cool. That's amazing if it happens.
But I mean, when it comes back to this, I think, you know, this is some good stuff. I think, you know, Huawei is really killing it. And I think that we're going to look at this, at those phones as, you know, pretty significant players for the next 6 months.
They are selling more phones than Apple, but are they going to be able to sell more phones in the high-spec segment too? Are they going to overtake the high-end XS, you know?
Potentially. I thought the numbers that they overtook Apple in sales.
Yeah,
it's not in profit.
That's
nobody
if you
ever
include all the cheap ones, right?
That's not counting profits, yeah. Though. But I think the thing about Apple, look, I mean, the problem with Apple is that the new phones they just launched, their camera is barely catching up with what the Pixel 2 did last year. And now we have the Pixel 3, which just blows up. We've got the Mate 20 Pro, that are, you know, just pushing the envelope beyond what we did with the P20 and P20 Pro. Like, where is Apple in this game? Their camera doesn't hold up, right? And number one thing people want out of their phone today, imaging. Number two, battery life.
So there you go.
5,000 milliamp hour battery
50%
life.
50% longer battery, double the battery.
Now it's really big, so it's not for everybody, right? Remember, there's also a Mate 20 Lite.
Yeah.
Right? That was announced at IFA. So you got some choices.
And that's only 200.
The Mate 20 Lite, everybody's reviewed it, said it's great for the price.
Cool. All right, so let's see if the US is going to allow these phones into their market, because they're still blocked.
Not
right?
For a while, I don't think. It has everything to do with Trump.
But it's
until our regime, until we lose that shitty regime we have, it's not going to change.
Yeah, but Obama was blocking Huawei already. They were never
blocking them during Obama. They're just, you know, you could have sold it. The carriers weren't interested during Obama. The carriers just started getting interested with the Mate 10 last year, and then the Trump regime blocked them because they told the carriers, if you do this, we're gonna be getting you in trouble. So, you know,
so
what do you do?
If I was China, you know, if I was the emperor of China, I would say, you want to block our Huawei's? Okay, no more iPhones in China. And not even just no more iPhones for sale, no more iPhones are allowed to be manufactured.
The problem is
anymore.
That rich people in China want the iPhone because it's a status symbol, so that's never going to happen.
Yeah, but you know,
that's you know I'm telling the truth.
I thought, you know, I thought they were strong. And like,
you know I'm telling the truth.
Yeah, it's funny how many Huawei employees around here I've seen with iPhones.
People, once they get a taste of iOS, they never go back, you know?
But you prefer Android, of course.
Oh, yeah. Right.